The Apple AirPods Max are not cheap headphones. They're $550 US, and yet they're already flying off shelves. But hold on a second, Apple haters. Don't facepalm yet. This is a good thing because the AirPods Max don't suck, and the more people there are out there listening to good headphones, the better. But as a Samsung user who wears an Apple Watch for some reason, I've got to ask myself, is there any reason to buy these if you're not already crotch deep in Apple's ecosystem? Let's discuss that. After this message from RidgeWallet. RidgeWallet wants to redefine the wallet with its compact frame and RFID blocking plates. Check out how they can keep your wallet bulge down and use offer code Linus to save 10% and get free worldwide shipping. We gotta start with sound quality because that's what everybody wants to know anyway. For comparison, we've got the ever popular Sony XM4s and Bose 700s, and by popular demand, the drop THX Pandas, which I happen to personally really, really like. The truth is that all of these headphones sound great, with the caveat that we, of course, are talking about consumer electronics that you're using wirelessly, probably to stream music from a service like Spotify. That means you're probably using your smartphone as a source without the aid of an external amp or DAC. And yes, we know that there are higher fidelity solutions out there, but the thing is, not everybody wants to carry around an extra brick, and lots of people like the convenience of not having a wire. Of course, the question is, which of them is the most great? Compared to the Sonys and the Bose, frankly, I gotta go with the AirPods Max, albeit not by a huge margin. Discerning listeners might think that it's a big margin, but I would hazard a guess that your average person won't hear much difference between any of these four headsets. Assuming though that you are a discerning listener, how do the AirPods Max compare to the Pandas, which are also a cut above the other two? Well, that's trickier. I would call them similar in quality, but different. The Pandas are much more forward with crystal clear vocals right against your ear. The Maxes, however, have a greater sense of space, even on Android, and a heck of a lot more bass. In fact, I would call that their defining feature, like low, rumbly, sacral chakra type bass that makes the Pandas seem underwhelming by comparison and makes the Sonys sound loose and muddy. Don't believe me? Do a side-by-side during the macaroni in a pot section of WAP. Now, a purist might still opt for the Pandas given the choice between the two, as they support more audio codecs, including aptX HD and LDAC, and they advertise no digital signal processing as a selling point. Meanwhile, the H1 chip in each of the AirPods Max's ear cups enables them to use computational audio to enhance their active noise canceling and allow transparency mode, which, by the way, works really well to pass through the world around you. They also enable adaptive EQ, which adjusts the sound in real time according to the fit and seal of the ear cups. As for codec support though, it's AAC only, which is the codec used by iTunes. This'll probably be fine, or even preferred a lot of the time, but Android users should be aware that there's some evidence that AAC sounds better on iPhones than it does on some Android devices, because AAC is computationally more demanding, leading some power-optimized Android devices to downgrade the incoming audio to a lower bitrate. Speaking of EQ, the AirPods Max doesn't have a companion app like the Bose and Sony sets do, so there's no way to apply custom or even canned EQs according to your liking. You just get what Apple gives you, which I guess is pretty on brand for them. So make sure that you audition them thoroughly before you buy to make sure that you like their sound signature. Personally, I find them a little bit bright on the high end, which sometimes makes cymbals or even snare drums a bit fatiguing to listen to. Good thing I have this pillow. Where's an LTT store pillow? Get me a pillow. Ah yes, this CPU shaped pillow from LTTstore.com. Of course, Bluetooth headphones have never really been about the absolute best sound quality anyway. So how do the AirPods Max compare to the competition when it comes to features? On Android, not great. Out of the box, there's no wear detection for automatic pausing when you put them around your neck, no battery level indicator on your phone, and no virtual assistant support at all. However, If history is any indication, these features should end up available to Android users using a third-party app at some point. Then there's the settings that you can tweak only if you have an iOS device. For example, by default, this button right here toggles the headphones between active noise canceling on and transparency mode. But what if you want neither and you just want ANC off? Well, it can be done, but only by adjusting the button behavior on an Apple device. Same goes for updating device firmware and reversing the direction of the volume knob if you're one of those people who plays inverted. Then finally, there's the features that are simply just not there if you're an Android user. In other words, if you're an Apple customer who hasn't bought enough of their products to deserve all of the features, it's like, man, this is the kind of arrogant, anti-consumer bullshit that...
Focus.
Sorry. The AirPods Max are advertised as supporting seamless movement between your iPhone, iPad, and Mac. And if you're listening to music on your laptop and a call comes in, they're supposed to switch over automatically, which works great for Apple, but guess what? The Sonys and Bose do that as well, except that on a PC or Android, when I try to do the same thing with AirPods Max and a laptop, they have to disconnect from one in order to play a signal from the other. So Apple got me for $550 here, but evidently I'm still a second-class citizen. Same thing goes for their spatial audio feature, but even though that one's really cool, I'm less upset about it because understandably it requires proprietary software on the source side. Spatial audio is a 3D sound mode that attempts to mimic the home theater experience by tracking the headphone's position so that when you turn your head, the sound stays put instead of following you around. I would definitely recommend using it for movie watching, but only if you've got an eye device. Get wrecked. While we're on the subject of Apple shenanigans, let's talk wires. Yes, it's true that Bluetooth headphones can sound better when listening to them wired, but Apple doesn't seem to want you to do that. Unlike every one of these other pairs of headphones, the AirPods Max don't come with the cable to plug them in. Or rather, they do come with a cable, a Lightning to USB Type-C that seems like it should work, but it doesn't. Instead, you need a Lightning to 3.5mm audio cable, which Apple is happy to suggest as an add-on item at just $35. Of course, you won't be able to charge your headphones while listening this way. Oh, and if you want to plug into your phone, you will also need a dongle. Where did I put the dongle? Ah, there it is. That's exactly the problem with these things. Which, again, Apple doesn't include in the box anymore. But your Android phone may. Finally, this one's pretty bizarre. When you are listening wired, you can no longer use the crown button to pause or skip tracks by pressing on it, but then you can still adjust the volume and toggle your ANC? Just like, why? Why doesn't Linus get to the point here? All right, here we go. If you're an Android user, the answer is no. Don't buy the AirPods Max unless you, one, have access to an iPhone so that you can update your firmware and adjust your settings. Two, find a third-party app that helps reclaim otherwise lost features in a way that's not crappy to use, which, by the way, may require a subscription fee. And three, you really like the industrial design. Thing is, they're not a bad product at all. Like, there's a lot to like here. The headband is shockingly comfortable, even over long periods. I mean, I thought it was gonna be awful, but it's great. The fitment adjustment mechanisms are as beautiful as they are silent, and the aluminum ear cups and tactile volume knob feel way more premium than any of these other plastic sets. Oh, and by the way, I haven't used the bra thing all week, and it's been totally fine, so you're not obligated to use it. But in spite of all that, it's clear that Apple just doesn't want my money. These headphones are made for Apple enthusiasts who are already deeply locked into Apple's ecosystem, and if that's you, then the sonic performance, build quality, and the Apple magic really do combine to something that's not really overpriced so much as it's priced for people who really value those three things. If you only care about sound though,
where are they? There they are.
Just get the Pandas and EQ up the bass. And maybe check out our sponsor, Backblaze. Backblaze is a cloud storage solution that's easy to use and affordable, starting at just $6 a month. With Backblaze, you can back up your personal and/or business data and even use it as a B2 storage solution. Backblaze allows you to restore your files almost anywhere, and they even have mobile apps so you can access them on the go. You can even restore by mail by purchasing a restore via hard drive, and they will overnight it to you via FedEx. After you copy all the data, you can return the hard drive to them for a refund. So why wait? It's unlimited data backup at a fixed price, and you can try it out for free at backblaze.com/LTT and start protecting yourself from potential bad times at the link in the video description. If you guys are looking for something else to watch, maybe check out the video we did recently featuring the XM4s from Sony. They're pretty sweet.